Nikki Sauber, and as he just said, the title of my project is The Impact of Service. Can everyone hear me okay? I'm not a huge fan of microphones. We good? Okay. Impact of Service, Cultural Understanding and International Service Learning with Bridgewater State University. So first I'd like to take a minute to define exactly what International Service Learning, or ISL, is. ISL is a combination between, a four-credit international academic program and a community service project, usually one that relates to the topic being studied in that given trip. Bridgewater State University offers a variety of international travel programs for its students, including study tours, semester exchanges, and affiliate programs. All of these are offered through the Center for International Engagement, and those are all four-credit academic programs. The Community Service Center offers alternative break programs, which are short-term trips that travel to impoverished communities in Central America during school breaks, and those are for students who are not seeking academic credit. So by looking at these programs, I could see that Bridgewater currently does not have any defined international service learning programs. International service learning has recently become a big topic of research because it's been incorporated in many curricula in schools all around the world. On a personal level, ISL has many, many benefits, including the development of leadership skills, the enhancement of academic drive, and also the development of problem solving and teamwork skills, among other benefits. Institutionally, ISL creates opportunities to link up different schools, programs, and organizations around the world to create partnerships. Additionally, research has shown that ISL provides valuable and long-lasting education for students from all sorts of socioeconomic and cultural backgrounds. And the quote up on the screen there is from a 2006 study, and it basically summarizes the academic value of ISL by saying that it provides students with a feeling of being valued and feeling of doing work that's worthwhile, and also allows them to connect what they're learning in the classroom to to the real world. And so after looking at all of this research on ISL, I wanted to see what the role of community service is in Bridgewater's travel programs right now. So the purpose of my study is to determine how the presence or absence of a community service component has impacted the academic learning, cultural understanding, and overall senses of global interest and citizenship of BSU students who have recently participated in university-sponsored travel. So to access my sample, I contacted the Center for International Engagement to obtain lists of students who have gone on study tours, semester exchanges, and affiliate programs between 2009 and 2011. And then I contacted the Community Service Center to receive lists of students who have participated in alternative break trips during those same years. So all in all, there were 427 students contacted. You can see the breakdown in the bubble on the side. And all of those students were emailed with a survey to evaluate their travel experiences, which include demographic questions, questions specific to their program, and also questions on a Likert-type scale that allowed them to evaluate their experiences. In that email, I asked for volunteers to conduct qualitative interviews with me to further elaborate on their travel experiences. And the first 10 respondents were interviewed, and I recorded and coded those for further analysis. Now on to my preliminary results. So all in all, there were 80 respondents. They range in age from 19 to 61, and with the majority being in their early 20s. Over 3/4 of the sample were female. A majority of them were seniors or recent graduates of Bridgewater, and all but 5% indicated that they were American citizens. As for the type of program, over half of the respondents had gone on study tours with Bridgewater, and nearly 1/4 of them had been on the alternative break program. So I tried to make sure I had a significant chunk of students who had just done the community service trips. And as you can see, the years that were traveled are relatively well dispersed. So between the 80 respondents, 35 different countries are visited, and rather than listing them all for you, I broke them down into the continents. You can see the largest percentage went to North America, but it's important to distinguish with that that nobody traveled to the United States or to Canada. It was all in Central America. And for the community service variable, which is probably the most important independent variable in this study, 63% of the respondents indicated that there was no community service component in their trip. Of that 63% without community service, 74% wished that they did have an opportunity to do community service while traveling abroad. So I grouped my respondents by the community service variable, that is, whether or not there was a community service component in their trip. And then I conducted independent t-tests to compare the mean scores of each group for each of the 12 questions in the Likert type scale. And although I did make up a t-value table for all of the different questions, to make my data a little bit more manageable, I broke it down into four different variable categories that measure larger concepts. And I compared the group means of those categories for analysis. So my first group measured academic learning. That included two questions from the scale, which for time's sake you can read. And for the academic impact, the data was not statistically significant. However, the interviews were able to reveal some more subtle results about the value of community service and academic learning while abroad. It seemed that the students who participated in short-term trips without community service activities took away less long-term learning than those that went on short-term trips with community service, because the most lasting memories and the most lasting knowledge, according to many of the students that I interviewed, they said came from the one-on-one interactions with the local and native citizens of the country that they visited. And those sort of interactions are more accessible when there's a structured community service component included within the trip. For those who went on semester exchanges, they said that the length of the trip almost necessitated them to adapt, to learn, to just basically get by in the country. And so the academic value of semester exchanges should not be understated, regardless of the community service component. And also, many respondents mentioned the role of journaling, because some of the programs required students to keep a journal during their travels. And although this might not have been a purely academic piece of writing, many of them said that this was more valuable to them to recount some of the facts and experiences that they had than any of the essays or reports that they would have had to write about their trip otherwise. My second variable group measures cultural understanding, and that included four questions. And this was a very statistically significant variable group. And the data complemented the interview results, because many of the students said that direct interaction with the country's native people was key to understanding the culture of that country, rather. And as I said before, the structured community service component allows a comfortable venue for students to interact one-on-one with locals, regardless of the language barrier and regardless of socioeconomic barriers, too. One student who went on a community service trip said, "You learn through the people what they think their country is about. They're proud of their country everywhere you go, so that's who you learn from." Makes sense to me. My third variable group measures global interest, which is overall interest in just traveling abroad and studying foreign cultures. The bar graph in this one is nearly equal, and there was a very small difference in means for this variable group, which is not surprising, because most people who go abroad usually come back with some sort of travel bug, not necessarily sickness, though sometimes, but sometimes just a general interest in learning more and going traveling more. However, in the interviews, it showed to me that respondents with community service experience tend to back their global interest with more compassionate reasons. That is, they went abroad and they saw a social need or some kind of social ill, and they felt a need to do more and to be more in their global community. One student said, "When I do travel in the future, I'm definitely going to look into how I can not just go to a country, but how to get involved with a country." And my fourth variable group I created to distinguish between general global interest and interest in serving the global community. And so this included three questions, and this was the most statistically significant variable group that I found, because it really connected the value of community service with international learning and global citizenship. Because the eye-opening interactions that students have during community service trips or any kind of community service experience while abroad really inspires them to, as I said, to do more and be more in the global community. And two quotes really captured the different sides of this variable group. One student who had no service experience during her trip said, "I would have liked to feel like I did some good, like I was a better person for having gone. I feel good myself, but I don't feel like anyone else felt good because of me." And in contrast, the student who went on a trip with service said, "Kids are the same in every culture. You realize these kids to be your nephews or your cousins or whatever. It just helps you realize that we're all connected and that we're all responsible for each other." I really like that quote. And so briefly, I'd just like to touch on the limitations and challenges I've faced in my research so far. I had a bit of trouble accessing some of the lists of students who traveled through the Center for International Engagement because they had not yet put those into their digital data files. And also, some of the email addresses that were given to me for the students to contact were expired because the students had graduated and their emails had been deactivated. Also, the emails I did send, I had a fairly low response rate, and that's probably because it's summer vacation and checking your email isn't necessarily the first thing that comes to mind. And also, my mentor, Dr. Tan, has been absolutely wonderful, but she's also been in China for the whole entire duration of my project. So she's living the dream that I want to be traveling, but luckily I've been able to reach out to the faculty and staff and students involved in this project and in Bridgewater. And a special thanks to Dr. King for sitting down with me and helping me figure out SPSS, because it's a nightmare. But most importantly, the future implications of this study. I'd like to collect more data, possibly, to expand my results. And I'd also like to publish my results to add to the previous body of research on ISL. Most importantly, though, I'd like to present my findings to the Center for International Engagement, the Community Service Center, and the Service Learning Program at Bridgewater to inform them of my results and also suggest the development of an international service learning program at Bridgewater State University. Based on my preliminary results, it really seems like the addition of an ISL program would help Bridgewater create more opportunities to develop the kind of global citizens that the value or that the mission of the university is really trying to create. Thank you.